have been. I want you to have joy, cause can't nobody take that from you. I see you smiling.
In the beginning, God creates the heavens and the earth in 6 days. He makes Adam and Eve, who spend their days with God, until they give in to temptation by eating from a forbidden tree. Sin enters the world, and things get so bad that God floods the earth and starts over with Noah and his family. Years later, God calls Abraham to follow him with the promise to make Abraham the father of a great nation. Abraham obeys, and God gives him a son, Isaac. Isaac's son Jacob has 12 sons. Joseph, Jacob's favorite, becomes second in command of Egypt. God uses him to save his entire family and Egypt from starvation. Hundreds of years later, the Israelites are slaves in Egypt. Moses is called to lead the Israelites out of slavery. Joshua takes over after Moses and leads the people into the promised land. After Joshua, God raises up judges, temporary military leaders like Deborah, Gideon, and Samson, who protect and fight for God's people. The people tire of this leadership, and they call for a king. God gives Israel King Saul, King David, and then King Solomon. But it's all downhill from here. The people rebel. The kingdom of Israel is divided, and everyone turns their back on God. Prophets like Elijah, Isaiah, Micah, and Jeremiah warn that if people don't repent of their sins, there will be consequences. But the people ignore their warnings. The divided kingdoms are conquered, and God's people face captivity in foreign lands. People like Daniel show great courage and stand up for God when no one else does. Some of the exiled people return to the promised land, but for 400 years, God is silent. No prophets, no miracles, and no angel visitations. But then, the silence is broken when Jesus is born. He lives a perfect life, teaches truth, and performs miracles, proving he is God. He shows us the full extent of God's love by taking our place and dying on the cross for our sin. He is placed in a grave, but 3 days later, Jesus rises again, conquering sin and death. His followers travel the world, sharing the good news of his love and starting churches. We now are part of this story, and we have the chance to change the world and share his love, because one day, he will crack open the sky and he will return. It's the greatest story ever told.
Hey everybody, welcome to church. We got about 5 minutes before the service starts, so here are some church appropriate dance moves you can do whenever the Spirit moves you. So get on up and let's sweat to some scriptures. Or maybe not, or just let's go. Here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4. Shirts on the face. Skin on the face. Yeah. Bring it together. Here we go. Let it go. You take the stone, you let it go, you're unhindered by armor. Let that elbow sway. Elbow, 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 elbow. One of my personal favorites. Resurrection. You gotta get down to get back. Keep working, guys, keep working. You're doing great. I'm doing great. I'm getting a little tired. Stomp hard, stomp hard, stomp hard. You're crushing it, crushing it, crushing it. Yeah. that whip going. Scare those tax collectors. Those merchants.
Yeah,
those merchants.
Give God some praise. Amen. It's a blessing to be in the house of the Lord once again. Glory be to God. Amen. Oh, come on now. Amen. I don't see, sometimes we go through some trials and it can affect our well-being. But I want you to know that God is still on the throne. God is still in the blessing business. God is still touching and healing. God is still lifting up. God is God. If you don't mind, let's give him some praise up in here this morning. Glory be to God.
Amen.
It's time for our devotional part of the service. We ask that you put your hands together and lift us your voices as we go higher in the Lord. Amen.
in the room.
To go into God's word, I ask that anybody that's sitting, that's able to stand, would you please stand at this time reading God's holy word? Make a joyful noise unto the Lord.
Yes.
all ye land. Serve the Lord with gladness. Come before his presence with singing. Know ye that the Lord, he is God. It is he that has made us and not we ourselves. We're his people and the sheep of his pasture. Enter into his gates with thanksgiving and to his courts with praise. Be thankful unto him and bless his name. For the Lord is good, his mercy is everlasting, and his truth endures to all generations. This morning for your hearing, I read Psalms 100. May the Lord add a blessing to the readers, but more so the doers of his most holy word. At this time, you may be seated now in the presence of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Heavenly Father, we just want to thank you for waking us up this morning, Heavenly Father. Just thank you, Heavenly Father, because we know someone didn't wake up this morning, Heavenly Father, because it was your will, Heavenly Father, if they did, Heavenly Father. Heavenly Father, we want to thank you for your grace and your mercy. Most of all, your grace and your mercy. Heavenly Father, just thank you. Thank you for our strength today, Heavenly Father. Thank you for our help, Heavenly Father. Just thank you, Heavenly Father, because we know you are our protection, Heavenly Father. You comfort us at the time when we need, Heavenly Father. Heavenly Father, just thank you for everything. Heavenly Father, just thank you for the sun coming up this morning, Heavenly Father. So we wouldn't be in the darkness, Heavenly Father. Heavenly Father, we just want to thank you for everything. Even the clothes on our back. And the food we have in our house, Heavenly Father. Heavenly Father, thank the one that don't. Bless them, Heavenly Father, if they don't have one. Just bless them. Know that you're there for them, Heavenly Father. Heavenly Father, just thank you for everything. Heavenly Father, just thank you. Going to the nursing home, Heavenly Father. Touch them right now, Heavenly Father. Heavenly Father, into the jail, Heavenly Father. Touch them too, Heavenly Father. Just let them know you there for them, Heavenly Father. Heavenly Father, just bless our armed forces, from the Army to the Navy to the Marines. Heavenly Father, bless the first family of the United States, Heavenly Father. Heavenly Father, bless our family, and Lou Malilia, Heavenly Father, First Lady, Bishop, and Lady Slater, Heavenly Father. Touch their family, just bless them, Heavenly Father. Heavenly Father, just thank you, Heavenly Father, for everything. Heavenly Father, just thank you this morning for legs to walk on, Heavenly Father. Because we know some got legs that can't walk, Heavenly Father. So just thank you, Heavenly Father. Heavenly Father, just thank you. As we go through this day, Heavenly Father, we try to be blessing of Black history, Heavenly Father. As we fellowship today, Heavenly Father. Heavenly Father, just thank you for where you brought us from to, where you got us to now, Heavenly Father. Because we know every day is Black history for us, Heavenly Father. Just thank you, Lord. Thank you for everything, Heavenly Father. Jesus, just thank you, Heavenly Father. As we walk, just know if you in trouble, Heavenly Father, just lay your burden on Jesus, Heavenly Father. He will take care of you, Heavenly Father. Because we know he do all things through him, Heavenly Father. Heavenly Father, just thank you, Heavenly Father. Thank you for everything. Heavenly Father, bless anyone that's sick right now, Heavenly Father. Reach out and touch him, Heavenly Father. Heal their body up, Heavenly Father, that they may be able to have the strength to get through the day, Heavenly Father, and every day. Heavenly Father, just thank you. Thank you for your grace, Heavenly Father, once again. Heavenly Father, just thank you. This is my servant cry. I pray in the name of Jesus. Amen.
I can't do nothing if I don't have you. You are the air that I breathe, song that I sing. Without you would be so confused. Can't imagine my world turning without you.
How many know that God is everything to you? Oh, yes.
I bow before the King. you're my master. You're my savior. You're my ruler. You're my redeemer. Yes, you're my provider. Oh, you're my shelter. You're my father.
Father.
Oh, some people don't have the father, but you're my father.
Father.
Yeah, but you're my father.
Father.
Oh, you're my father.
Father.
And you're my father because your name is Jesus.
Yeah.
praise. Hallelujah. He's so worthy. Somebody say hallelujah.
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 Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
This morning, the one who put breath in each and every one of our bodies. He didn't put breath in one person's body, and you found yours on your own. But just look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, the same breath he put in your body, I thank God for putting it in my body. Because without him, I wouldn't be here. I would cease to exist. Without the Lord who's been on my side, where, somebody tell me where, I'll tell you where I'd be. I'd be dead and gone, I'd be tore up from the floor, I'd be messed up all around up. Oh, without him, I would cease, or I wouldn't even be here. Without him, you wouldn't even be here. Oh, look at y'all, the neighbor, and say, neighbor. Say, I'm just so glad me being here didn't depend on me trusting him. Because even when we didn't deserve it, God said, I'll give him another day. I'll give him another chance. I'll give him another opportunity. I'll give him another reason. I'll give him another breath. I'll give him another step. I'll give him another opportunity. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Because if us being here depended on how much we love him, how much we obey him, and how much we adore him, say we all be laying down right now. We all be slain right now. We'd all be knocked out right now. We all be dead if our life, this moment, depended on this. Oh, yeah. Yeah, yeah. You know that time. If your life depended on that time, y'all remember that time. Everybody got a that time in their life. You know that time when you was hoping nobody saw you. When you was for sure nobody saw you. But the Lord saw you. You remember that time? Had our life depended on that time? We wouldn't even be here. Had our life depended on that time? But somebody said, oh, but the grace of Jesus. Oh, but the grace of Jesus. Oh, but the grace of Jesus. All over me, all around me. It covers my past. It watches out for my future. It blocks anything trying to come at me from the side. Somebody said, oh, the grace. Oh, thank you, Jesus, for the grace. Thank you for your grace and your mercy. Oh, bless him. Good morning. Good morning.
Good morning.
I pray that you came on. Oh, no, what's the word we learned Wednesday night? Your garment. You got your garment on. You got your praise on. See, Wednesday night, you know, y'all gonna have to make it, those who hadn't been making it to Wednesday night. You gonna have to come on out where you can catch up with us. But that's all right, we're gonna give you a short lesson right about now. What we've been talking about is that praise is a weapon. And we learned that praise is a garment that we must put on.
If you want to war with the enemy, you can't ball up your fists, because you'll just be hitting air or hitting your brother and sister. But if you really want to strike a mighty blow, put your garment of praise on. When you put your garment of praise on, that gives you the power to fight the enemy. It gives you the power to overcome sickness. It gives you the power to come over tiredness. It gives you the authority and the power to defeat the enemy. Somebody put on that garment of praise. You got your praise on. Yeah. Yeah, sometimes folks say you got your praise on and folks think they just need to start dancing and running. But I tell you, it's a lifestyle. It's a garment that you have to wear 24/7. Do you have your praise on? Your praise garment, is it on in the middle of the night? Is it on in the early morning? Is it on while you're going to work, while you're going to school, children? Put your garment of praise on. That's the only way you're going to survive. Yes. Because when them fiery darts come at you. I mean, it done had some fiery darts come at them before. Be it sickness, financial challenges, your job, your loved ones, whatever those darts were. When you put on that garment of praise, you just praise yourself right on through. That's just saying, Lord, I trust you. I trust what you put on me. This garment of praise. We're going to ask Evangelist to come forth. Evangelist Brian, she's going to do our responsive reading this morning. She forgot. She done praised herself. You don't have to put your shoes on. She done praised herself on up out of her shoes. That's all right. If you don't have, you don't have to put them on. And hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. If you have yet to stand, please rest upon your feet as we now begin with our responsive reading. Evangelist Brian. Amen.
Praise the Lord, everybody. Praise the Lord, everybody. Praise the Lord, somebody. Praise the Lord, anybody. The Bible says to let everything that has breath praise the Lord. I dare you to open up your mouth and give God a praise. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I don't know about you, but I'm excited about the Lord on today. About the Lord every day. I know I'm up here to do responsive reading, but God is so good, and I got my praise on, and I don't need nobody in my way when I get ready to get down with the Lord. Amen. Move out of my way. You ain't gotta like what I'm doing, but God said he inhabit the praise of his people. So I am his people, and I want to get my praise on. Go on into our responsive reading for today. And it says to be obedient to the word of God by discipleship. 2 Timothy 2 and 15. Congregation. Jesus Christ in our witnessing to the lost and backsliders.
Matthew 28:19-20.
Promoting a spirit-filled worship service. Flowing with true praise, Psalms 150. Congregation.
Giving cheerfully and regularly to the cause of Christ while developing our stewardship. Malachi 3:10, Luke 6:38.
Implementing community-based outreach programs, meeting its spiritual, physical, and financial needs. Matthew 5:13-16. Congregation.
Therefore, living holy and loving unconditionally, our brothers and sisters in Christ. Romans 12:1, John 13:34-35.
The vision statement for New Millennium Bible Fellowship Praise Center is altogether helping the hopeless, providing healing, peace, and true praise. New Millennium Bible Fellowship Praise Center. You matter. We care. God provides. Amen, amen. Oh, now we will have our welcome by our beautiful sister Daphne. Pow. Oh, and Zoe.
Giving our praises to God, honor to bishops. Giving our praises to God, honor to Bishop Slayer, Pastor Slayer, honor to you, our brothers and sisters in Christ. All our first time gifts, please stand in the presence of the Lord.
Amen.
If you don't mind, can you please share with us your name and who invited you? Yes, ma'am.
My name is Hope McGee. Sister Susie Burgess Hardaway invited us, and these are my children, O.C. Jones and Jalen.
That's your goddaughter. Amen. Well, welcome. Yes, sir.
Hi, my name is Demetrius Duffy, and I'm here with Minister Donald Wright.
Amen.
Nicole Warren, also with Minister Donald Wright.
Amen. Well, welcome. Yes, ma'am.
Praise the Lord. I'm a psychic grandson, and this is my son, Jerry, and we're so happy to be here to watch and praise God with the saints.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Welcome. You guys may be seated. Thank you so much. Yes, ma'am.
I'm Terrell Prophet. I am originally from New Orleans, Louisiana, and I am here visiting Bishop Slater, is like my older brother.
Hey, hey.
Well, welcome. We want to say thank you to all of our guests for being here this morning. We do pray that something is said and done that will bring you closer to Christ and also back to New Millennium Bible Fellowship Praise Center. Amen.
Amen.
If you have already received our welcome card, please fill it out and turn it in, do an offering a little later on, doing service. We also have a special treat immediately following morning worship for our first time guest. Sister Karen here in the middle aisle has something special just for you. So please do not leave till you receive what Sister Karen has. Amen.
Amen.
New Millennium Bible Fellowship family, please stand. Our nursery is open this morning to all of our babies that are 3 years and younger, and we will bring them back. We have special guests in the house this morning. Please help to make them feel welcome with a holy hug and kiss, and the J. Lee Slater Sanctuary Mime will be ministering. Amen.
I thought about that. I know, right?
I'm telling you, tell everyone.
I'm telling you.
So you're
Wonderful day. Truly, it is a blessing to be in the house of the Lord. I don't know about you, but I'm grateful that I am being seen and not viewed, and it is truly a blessing to be here. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Good morning. I bring you your announcements for February 28th, 2016. AOP2, Unrestricted Praises 1 and 2, will have practice on Monday, February 29th from 7 to 8:30 p.m. Jaylee Mass Choir Rehearsal will be this Tuesday, March 1st, 2016 at 7:30 p.m. Praise Team Directors and Musicians at 6:30. Please see Minister Guthrie. Prayer service is held every Sunday at 8 a.m. sharp. Please see Sister Karen Willis for more details. Amen. Amen. New Partners Orientation is every third Sunday at 9 a.m. Please see Deacon Cole for more details. The next orientation will be Sunday, March 20th. New Millennium Bible Fellowship Praise Center schedule for February and upcoming events. All of New Millennium Bible Fellowship Praise Center is requested to attend today.
Today!
today. We're having our musician appreciation. Woo, 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 woo. Amen. We are so grateful and just blessed in the Lord for our musicians who give of their time, talent, treasure. It's not just on Sundays. They are here throughout the week. They are great leaders. And so we are definitely excited to be able to appreciate them today. Please make sure that you do your $25 offering. It's a love offering that we're asking every partner to do. Make sure you mark it on your envelope for today. Amen. Amen. We have our fellowship dinner today. Woo, woo, woo. Amen. I will have to say, I walked back there to Ben, have gone all out, and I didn't have to decorate nothing. Y'all, I'm so excited. It is awesome. I didn't have to work at all. I'm just so excited we're going to be able to go and take and partake. So please, if you please stay, and men will see Minister Brown and for assignments for after service. Amen. Amen. Sunday, March 6, 2016, it's Harvest America at AT&T Stadium. Amen. Don't forget that we will be, we still have some of the flyers, and you pass those out. They make great witnessing tools, but that is next Sunday in the, and it doesn't have the time, but I know it's on there. What's that, 5, 6? It's, okay, yeah. There it is. Amen. All right, YPC Youth Praise Conference is coming up. Yay! So excited. It's going to be April 1st and 2nd, 2016 at Care Center Ministries. It's $20 per youth, but they won't get a shirt because the first deadline has already passed. But it's still an awesome opportunity. And that is a Friday-Saturday event. So it's going to be Friday night and then all day Saturday. So please make sure that you do that. All of the youth for New Millennium should definitely do it. But if there's any outside youth, maybe you have a niece or nephew or someone, please make sure to see Minister Guthrie, or you can see several people. You can see me. We'll get you the information. Amen. Amen. New Millennium Bible Fellowship Praise Center outing at Free Spirit pastor and wife anniversary. Amen. Amen. It's going to be Sunday, March 13th. The Fine Arts will be ministering, and Bishop Slater will be the main speaker. Amen. The, you know, I don't ever say this word right. The Usher. The Usher Ministry will be having a basket raffle giveaway drawing for a girl basket and a boy basket. The drawing will be held March 23rd, 2016. The tickets are only $1. Please see Henny Usher for more details. Yeah, I promise I got a couple of degrees. I just can't say Usher. We'd like to bless God for the supporters and tithes for this ministry for the third Sunday in March. Inside of your weekly services, please govern yourselves accordingly. Amen. 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 I feel like singing, she's your queen.
Oh, stop. Amen. 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 We just want to make emphasis again today is our musicians' appreciation. Amen. We have an awesome speaker, man of God, here to give the word. Amen. And we want to celebrate those that God have placed in our care. Understand, in our care. So we care for them. We appreciate them. Please, if you have not given what's been asked of you, please make sure you do so this morning. Amen. 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 We also want to acknowledge those on yesterday. They were calling themselves the Green Hornets, I believe. But the evangelism ministry, Sunday school ministry, partnered up together. See, and that's the example that Bishop and I have been conveying to all of the ministries. We want the different ministries to partner up with the evangelism ministry. It's not just for one or two to go out, but when your ministry partners up, you can go and witness in the capacity of even your ministry. So we bless God for those who went out on yesterday. Just time, talent, and treasure, right? Time, talent, and treasure. Amen. And we even have families that have come today out of a result. Amen. All you have to do is walk and open your mouth. And if you can't walk, just drive your car and let the window down or something. Amen. But we bless God for what he's doing here in this house. We thank God for each and every one of you that are carrying on and doing what's asked of you to be done. So we're encouraging all of our ministries to be signing up with the evangelism ministry and the Sunday school ministry and partner up with them also to increase. Somebody say increase.
Increase.
See, if I was talking about your pocketbook, you'll be hollering increase. be up shouting and everything else. But somebody say, increase for the kingdom. Now that ought to bring you to your feet right there. Because when you're going to the kingdom, that's less going to hell. And we ought to be happy about that. Amen. Amen. He said, go ye therefore. Amen. We have to go ye therefore. And you know what the Bible said? It talks about how sheep beget sheep. You can't send the under shepherd out there to go have no sheep. He can't do that. It's for us to get the sheep. Amen. Sheep beget sheep. Amen. So each and every one of us here today, under the sound of my voice on Ustream, it is your obligation. If you say you love the Lord, if you have accepted Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, to open your mouth and share the goodness of the Lord. If you don't have a Bible teaching church to go to, you need to find a Bible teaching church. One that stands on the Word of God. One that is unmovable. One that loves the Lord and loves what He's doing and how He does it. Now, if you don't know where that is, let me just go ahead and let you know. New Millennium Bible Fellowship Praise Center is a perfect place to serve God, well, to worship God and to serve man. So you are invited to New Millennium Bible Fellowship Praise Center, not only to come and spectate, but come on and participate. Amen. Amen. We encourage you. Amen. So we thank God for those who have stepped out on there yesterday. We thank God for the concert that's coming up with the Cross America. We want to make sure everyone has flyers and Harvest Across America. What did I say? Okay, Harvest America. I'm sorry. I don't know what I said, but praise the Lord. Amen. God in America. Let's put it. And we need to be there. And we need to get as many other folks there. Amen. To hear a word. Amen. Amen. And the thing about it is that if you didn't know, when you get these flyers, when you get the prayer cards and so forth, Evangelist Bryant, stand up and wave your hand. If you need more flyers, or it's completely free. But that ticket also will allow you to get their name and number and everything where they may be prayer partners, or where you may pray on behalf of the people that's seeking, needing help. Okay, and I believe we have a video. Amen, amen.
I was suffering and I didn't know how to deal with it.
I joined the gang, fought with everybody. I was, you know, doing drugs.
I lived in my car for almost a year. No hope. And one day I chose to take out my life.
It was a life filled with emptiness and loneliness.
I started going through a phase of, like, cutting myself.
I've been struggling with heroin addiction since I was 13.
I was feeling so much pain, and all I wanted to do was just mask that pain.
I had a very strong fear of dying, death and dying.
I was gang raped in Mexico, fell into the depths of alcoholism, hospitalized for suicidal tendencies. You name it, I went through it.
Southern California, the Golden State. Some consider it paradise. This is where everyone wants to live, work, and play. On a typical summer's evening, the Los Angeles Angels of Anaheim draw faithful fans to Angel Stadium. Cheers, tension, excitement fills the air. Prayers are offered up to the baseball gods as the Angels rally to victory or hands hang low in the disappointment of defeat. On this weekend in late August, the Angels take the field again, but 2,337 miles away in Cleveland, Ohio, in Anaheim, a different team takes the field. In this homestand, the stakes are higher. It still boils down to wins and losses. There isn't necessarily a division title at stake. There is no pennant race in play here. However, the wins and losses are eternal. There are souls in the balance.
Well, I tell you what, I used to play professional baseball. To come to an event like this and to be a part of God's kingdom business is what life is all about.
It's really exciting just to see people from Southern California and just different places of California come together in the Angel Stadium, worship God, you know. It's one of the coolest feelings of fellowship that I've had, like, in Orange County. It's really awesome.
I can tell there's a lot of religious people that just love God and just want to be with God. It's the first time I've been out here, but it's really sick. I'm really excited about it. Definitely a lot of Christians out here. I have no idea what I'm going to expect, to be honest with you. I just heard it's going to be amazing.
How many people invited a friend here to Harvest Crusade? We appreciate you guys. This is what this evening and this weekend's about, is telling people about Jesus and pointing them to Him, so we appreciate that.
You know, up until recently, I considered myself an atheist, and I don't know, I've been, you know, praying a lot recently, and I've been really trying to rekindle that connection that I lost with God or Christ or whatever it is, and I was praying the other day, and then they brought this up, and I thought, you know, this would be the perfect opportunity to try to kind of rectify what I'd lost.
Men, women, and children, whom by entering this stadium during this weekend, on this night, can take home with them not a souvenir or a signed jersey, or even the memory of witnessing an ESPN Top 10 play, but the comfort, peace, and assurance that their life can be changed today, for tomorrow, and for eternity. Pre-game superstitions may not be the case here, but pre-crusade jitters and rituals are still the norm. In the three-night event, over 105,000 people settled into their seats, with the crowd locked in and loaded, the bands cranked it up, and for lack of a better term, rocked the house. It's hard to imagine, in the middle of the decibel meters peaking, bass cabinets thumping, bands rocking, the stadium swaying, to one man, this is actually the calm before the storm.
You know, for a lot of people, a crusade's a time of celebration, gathering with family. It's actually a time of fun. But not for me. Not that I don't have fun, but I'm not here to enjoy myself. I'm here to deliver a message.
It's actually a very serious message. I believe that life and death hangs in the balance based on the decision that people are going to make tonight concerning Jesus Christ. So when I go on stage, I'm going to battle.
In a few moments, though, a storm will rage as Greg Laurie takes the stage. He will throw out a lifeline of hope to each and every person under the amplified sound of his voice.
Hello, Southern California. Good to see you all.
This is why Harvest Crusades exist, for such a time as this.
When you came in here tonight, you said, there's something different about this place. It's not like a baseball game. It's not like a rock concert. This is a place where God is present, you see?
You give life, you are love, you bring light to the darkness.
I wasn't raised, you know, going to church or learning anything, and this is the way that I need to live. This is what I need for a sense of peace and happiness.
Because I'm struggling with addictions, and He has to save me.
The way I was living wasn't getting me anywhere. I was in drugs, alcohol. But accepting Christ and coming here tonight made me realize that there is a God that's out there for me, and I'm just going to praise Him from now on and just dedicate my life to God.
My mom, she left me when I was a child, and she was addicted to crack cocaine and alcohol, so that really made me start to have separation issues, and I got into spice and cocaine, and I had a really rough go, you know what I mean? So I'm here now, and I'm trying to better my life, you know what I mean? I always tried to do it my way, and my way was not working, so it's time to do it God's way, and that feels great, and, you know what I mean? I'm ready to change.
Let's say you've got a call on your phone. Jesus Christ. Now you have two choices, accept or decline.
You brought it to our level, like with this, like social media and things like that.
So you slide the little bar over, hello, and you respond,
or you don't answer it. To not say yes is to say no. To not be for him is to be against him.
And I realize, you know what, it's time to not hesitate, but say yes, of course, and on the first ring and not wait any longer.
Christ is calling you right now, not on your mobile phone. He's knocking at the door of your heart and your life. What's your answer? Is it accept or decline? It's your choice.
All the earth will shout your praise. Our hearts will cry, these bones will sing. Great are you, Lord.
We have hope. Hope brings happiness.
So happy to be here. You won't believe my daughter, she changed one life to another one.
When I got here, I just realized this is where I needed to be, and it just got tears.
So here's a choice before you tonight. You can go away sad, you can go away mad, or you can go away glad. It's up to you.
The recognition, all the pain and suffering, my mom bringing me the whole thing, it was great.
God can forgive you of any sin you've committed.
You won't believe how bad she was. She was such an alcoholic. One time, she wanted to stab me with a knife. She did.
Put your faith in Jesus and leave this place with joy and happiness in your life and the hope of heaven when you die.
It's so beautiful. You will never forget this.
I can't stop crying. He said, you know, we need to go down there, Mom. This is a beautiful, beautiful moment for me.
You have no idea how much I've been praying for this. For me today, it's like a holiday.
I came, I'm fed, I'm full right now. I'm about to go home and just spread the word.
The power of the gospel changes lives. The storm is raised, but the lifeline of hope, of truth, of peace, of forgiveness, of knowing the angels in heaven are rejoicing. 10,759 men, women, and children were saved by committing their life to Jesus Christ. On this weekend, on this night, the home team wins. Great are you.
Amen. Praise the Lord. Amen. Just want to add on to that. That New Millennium Bible Fellowship is a follow-up church. And what happens is that as people fill out their commitment cards to Christ, then it goes all to the data bank room. And I'll be working in there also. And then those school cards and everything. And according to the zip code, they will assimilate or send the information to the churches in that zip code area of those who have given their life to Christ so that we can follow up, amen, and encourage our brothers and sisters in Christ, amen. Also, for those of who have been coming to Bible study and, you know, if you haven't prayed out loud, won't even pray when Bishop asks you to, you know you've been praying, you know you've been coming to Bible study, Sunday school, and you would like to also pray with those that are giving their life to Christ. You'll be able to do that also. There are some who was with us when we did the Billy Graham Crusade, and what you would do, you would be a prayer warrior on the grounds there. So when the people will come, you will give them the plan of salvation and pray with them and so forth. So again, all of that information Evangelist Bryant has, please make your way to see her. Don't miss out on this opportunity to serve. Amen. Amen. I'm going to turn it over to Deacon Minter right quick for offering. And then God bless us. A.O. will be coming. I'm sorry. I didn't see you.
I just wanted him to.
Oh, he wanted you. Okay. That was Minister, Evangelist Brian. Deacon Minter. Amen. Bless the Lord.
Good morning, church.
Good morning,
church.
Good morning.
It's offering time.
Praise the Lord.
Now, let me just say this. I know when you left this morning, men, You have what you're going to do an offering in one pocket, and you set aside some for what you're going to eat with this afternoon in the other pocket. And for you women, I know you put part of it in your purse on one side that you're going to put into service this morning, and the other part that you're going to pay for your food this afternoon. Well, guess what? I'm going to lighten your load a little bit. That separate pocket in a separate section of your purse, you can go ahead and put that in offering today because we're going to feed you. At no cost to you. So you don't have that excuse. Now, you might have some other excuses why you don't have it or what have you. But having to buy food this afternoon is not one of them. Now, if you leave here hungry today, it's on you and not us. So New Millennium is offering time.
Praise the Lord.
You're not in the hands of our ushers.
Amen.
Father God, we want to thank you for this blessing on the day, Father God. We want to thank you for those who gave, Father God, and those who had the Sabbath, had it not, Father God. Now, Father God, we pray that this all be used for the uplifting of your kingdom. These and other blessings, as Son, Jesus' name, amen.
Jesus will, I know he will.
I know he will.
He said he will. He'll fight my battle. He'll fight the sea.
Thank you. Praise the Lord, praise the Lord. Praise the Lord, praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Give me you, everything else can wait. Give me you, I hope I'm not too late. Lord, give me you, Lord, give me you, Lord, give me you, Lord, give me you. Give me you, everything else can wait. Lord, give me you, I hope I'm not too late.
Hallelujah. It says, I hope I'm not too late. I hope I'm not too late. Amen. Is the choir coming on now? The choir is coming, and as they come, just bless the Lord. Just say, Lord, I just pray I'm not too late. I'll put everything else to the side. I just want to give it all to you. For you're worthy. You're worthy, Lord. He's worthy to be praised, you know. So many times we get distracted and we always get sidetracked and everything. But I'll tell you, when you make up your mind, somebody say, just make up your mind. See, if you make up your mind, he'll make a way. He'll fulfill the desires of your heart. He said, if it's your desire, I will give it to you. If your desire is to be closer to me, I'll get closer to you. If that's your desire. All we have to do is just give it to him. Hallelujah. Let's bless the Lord for anointed Orkeo. Amen. Anointed Orkeo. Amen. Anointed dance. We bless God for how he's using them. And our babies at mine this morning. Amen. Sister Daphne and Brother Matthew are doing an awesome job. Bless God for each and every one of them. Thank you, parents, for having them out at rehearsals and practice and teaching them how to sacrifice that time so that they can make perfect what the gifts God has given them. Amen. That's what happens when you bring your babies out. When we participate, amen, we perfect the gifts that God has given us. Amen. Amen, amen. The J. Lee Slater Mass Choir, amen.
Thank you.
want to be just like you? How many want to be just like him? Amen. It's altar call time. We're going to ask if you will stand where you are. The ushers have new garments and covers and prayer cloths that they want to present. Amen. Minister Will, who's doing the prayer? As Minister Will come forth, Deaconess Booth will come with the prayer cloths and lay them here at the altar so they may be blessed. Amen. 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 We bless the Lord. We want to be just like you, Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Bless the Lord.
Bless the Lord.
Y'all ready to go higher?
Higher.
All right. Well, let every weight that easily besets you just lay it down right now. And we're just going to go to the Lord in prayer. Father, we thank you for another wonderful day. Lord, we bless your holy name. We thank you, Lord, for being our God and making us your people. We thank you, Lord, for making us who you made us and giving us an opportunity today to just celebrate not only our culture, Lord, but to celebrate Christ. And Father, as we celebrate our culture and we celebrate Christ today, Lord, we pray for healing. Healing in this nation, Lord. Healing of all his people, Father. Lord, we thank you for how you've been with us through all that we've been through. And Lord, we just bless you for continually being by our side. We thank you, Lord, for your continued presence with your Holy Spirit. We thank you, Lord, for what you are doing in each and every life represented here today. And Father, as we just lift you up, we thank you. And we ask you, Father, to forgive us for all sin, iniquity, transgressions. Anything, Lord, that we've done or said or even thought that didn't line up with your word, your will, and your way. And Father, we thank you for forgiving us and cleansing us of all unrighteousness. We thank you, Lord, for renewing our minds and renewing the right spirit in us, Lord. We thank you, Father, for the word that you're about to bring forth through your servant today. And we pray, Lord, that you use your servant mightily. We pray, Lord, that you prepare every ear, every heart to hear and receive your word today and walk it out in victory. For we love you, Lord, and we thank you, Father, for all you've done today, for all you've done all our lives, for all you've done throughout the history of our culture. We thank you, Father. Lord, we speak healing, peace, joy, prosperity, patience, long suffering, and deliverance in the mighty name of Jesus. We lift up our leaders here in the house, Father. We thank you for our bishop and our pastor, Lord. Thank you for all that you're doing in them, Lord. As they continue to pour out in us, Lord, pour out back into them, Father, hundredfold. And everything that they sow, Lord, let them reap a hundredfold in Jesus' name. We love you, Lord. We bless you. And let the whole house say amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Lord, as we bless these garments, Father, we thank you that they are holy and sanctified and set apart, Lord. We thank you for your anointing, Lord, that rests upon them. We thank you, Lord, that every person that touches them, Lord, let your Holy Spirit just be released. So that no devil in hell can come against us or hinder anything that you're doing in your house. We thank you, Lord, as we sanctify these cars. In Jesus' name, amen.
Stand to your feet.
He's alive. Jesus is alive.
He's
say Jesus is He's the light of the world. Down in my soul, Jesus. Why don't you just go on and praise Him? Put your hands together and praise the Lord.
Light up the world.
Jesus is. He's ever shining. Let's praise God. Put those Holy Ghost hands together and praise the Lord. Put your hands together and praise the Lord. Hallelujah, somebody. Y'all had to help me with that. I was scared. But God will. God will. Won't God do it? Somebody say yeah. Go on and touch your neighbor and say, neighbor, I don't know what you came to do, but I came to give God the praise in this place. If you've been blood-bought and you've been washed in the blood of Jesus, you ought to open up your mouth and tell the Lord, say, thank you. Thank you. Thank you, Lord. Yeah, yeah. Isn't God good? Didn't God do it for you? Won't He do it for you? Won't He make a way out of no way? Yes, He will. Yes to your will. And yes to your way. I got to lift up my hands now. And I got to praise the Lord. Because He brought me. He taught me. From a mighty long way. Yeah, 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 yeah. Glory to God. I'm excited. Let me go down and shut up. Amen. Glory to God. I'm excited. I'm going to go down and hurry up and shut up so I can let this man. I got to release the Titan. Amen. Holy, praise the Lord. Amen. Y'all know how we are. Amen. You have to praise, sinner. You better praise God. Amen. Let go and let God. Amen. How many of you want to let go and let God? How many of you looking for a blessing? How many of you looking for a breakthrough? Anybody need a financial breakthrough in the house? You ought to open up your mouth and say, Lord, I need a breakthrough. And I need a financial breakthrough. I need you to do something like you never did before. But guess what? Before you get it, you got to give it up to Him. When praises go up, anybody ready to praise the Lord? Anybody ready to have a Holy Ghost party in here? Y'all know New Millennium, you are at the Praise Center, and we welcome you to the Praise Center, where the Word of God goes forth. Got any praises in here? I'm going to give y'all 30 seconds to get out of these aisles and go on and let go and let God. I'm going to give you the count of three, and you got 30 seconds to go it on and let go and let God. One, two, three. Yeah! Come on. Y'all better put your hands up. Now that y'all got it good and ready, y'all done made your gravy, you're pouring it on your meat, now it's time to eat. Glory to God. We have a brother, he's a Louisiana boy. Yeah. My homeboy. Alice, man, you mess around a lot of my homeboy. Lawrence, Donald, all you see that? And I just gotta say this. I am so thankful today. I didn't get a chance, but I got a chance. First lady brought her to the back and greeted her. My home church, you know, my father, my late father, the great Dr. Joseph Clifford Prophet, amen. Y'all know how my heart was, and I always talked about him. I wanted him to get here, and the Lord chose to take him on home. But this morning, I'm so surprised, and I'm filled with joy that one of his daughters, Terrell Prophet, is here. And I want to thank you for being here, my sister. We was all singing in the choir together as young children. Raise your hands up to Terrell so everybody can see you. She's here this morning. I thank you for being here. She said next time she was in Dallas, she was going to come and fellowship with us, and she's here. She's a cosmetologist. She deal with mocha products and all that stuff. Am I right? That's family. You know, you got to know about them. Amen. So I want to thank God for you. You came on a beautiful day. We want to recognize our musicians. Certainly, this is a blessed day. The men are in charge. Where my men at in the house? I don't hear y'all, men. Y'all ain't making enough noise. These brothers been cooking. And we got some of our sisters saying, let's help y'all just a little bit. You know, we thank God for y'all sisters. Pastor Slater said, you got to do this, you got to do that. I say, we got it, baby, we got it, we got it. We don't do this all the time. But I just bless God for our brothers. We're trying to do something different from other churches, amen, where our brothers become more active. Amen. Hello, somebody. We got to become more active in our service, in our house, in the community, in our city, in our state. And so we're gonna be doing that. So brothers, don't sit down, amen, because it's time to get down. Hello, somebody. So I'm thankful. So amen. So I'm gonna go it on. I got to get my cue back there. Amen. Come on, Bishop. Amen. I'm just excited. Amen. So, but anyway, I want to introduce this man of God. He is a great friend of our Minister of Music, Alice Faye Guthrie. I had the opportunity to get to know him, amen, through her, and found out he's a homeboy from Louisiana. What part of Louisiana are you from? New Iberia. New Iberia. Now, hot sauce, that's right, the hot sauce. But in New Iberia, I played football with some guys, Gerald Broussard and all them. We played football at Tulane together. And I know, and John Hot Rod Williams was Sorrento down the street. He just passed, and so we're connected indirectly, amen. But I thank God for Reverend Donald. I've heard him sing, never had an opportunity to hear him preach. And let me tell you, you're in for a treat, Millennium. You're in for a treat, and he's gonna introduce his amen armor bearer, amen. That's coming. My brothers and sisters, let's raise our right hand and receive Reverend Donald Wright. Amen. Coming to us with the word of God. Tell him, preach. Reverend Donald Wright, preach. 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 Well, preach. I'm done.
All the people of God said amen.
Amen.
If you truly love him, clap your hands one more time all over this place. God is awesome, and he's worthy to be praised. God is awesome, and he's worthy to be praised. God is awesome, and he's worthy to be praised. Anybody know God is awesome this morning? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You may be seated if you can. We do bless God in this house. And first, I want to give my obedience to God. Amen. For just waking me up this morning, starting me on my way, giving me the activity of my limbs one more time just to open up my mouth and tell him thank you. I want to thank God for the angel of this house, Bishop Slater and Lady Slater. Give them a hand. Amen. 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 It's good to be in the house of God, and we're excited about what God is doing. I do want to recognize a few people. Minister John Taylor came with me from Bear Creek, and so I thank you for coming with me this morning. Amen. Amen. And I do also have some other friends. Minister Duffy and his fiance is here. They are faithful members of my Bible study I hold on Thursday nights. Amen. At the La Quinta Inn, and so we do bless God, and I thank God for you. Amen. Amen. And to all of you, it's just good to be in the house of the God. We give God glory. Could you give me an E flat, please? Amen. Amen. And I am running back to you. I see you standing there for me. I go astray when I don't have to cry no more, cause you're standing there for me, and I am running back to you. Why do I go astray when I know I am no good? When I'm on my own, can I say that again? And I am running back to you. I see you standing there for me. Why do I go away when I don't have to cry no more? You're standing there for me, and I am running back to you. Why do I go astray when I know I am no good? When I'm on my own. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So here I am to worship. Here I am to bow down. Here I am to say that you're my God. You're altogether lovely. Somebody lift your hands and say, here I am to worship. Here I am to bow down. Here I am to say that you're my God. You're altogether lovely. Oh, altogether worthy. Altogether wonderful to me.
Ghost, hallelujah, to see my sins upon the cross. I never know how much it costs, how much it costs to see my sins upon the cross. So here I am to worship. Here I am to bow down. Here I am to say that you're my God. You're altogether lovely. Yes, you are, God. You're altogether worthy. You're altogether wonderful to me. Father God, how we bless your name in this house. We stand in agreement this morning saying, here I am, just as I am. I surrender myself to you. God, we come not for a form or a fashion, God, but we come that you might get all the glory, all the honor, and all the praise, God. God, today, God, we praise just one audience, and that's you. You died for us. You bled for us. You were pierced in the side for us, but then you got up for us. And so the least we can do is open up our mouths and give you glory, honor, and praise because you're worthy. So God, speak through me. Remove self completely out of the way. Somebody needs to hear a word from you this morning. So God, rescue me from thee. God, I pray, God, that you would get all the glory, all the honor. It's in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Those of you who have your Bibles, turn with me to two references of scripture. I do want to recognize the verse of the occasion, and that's Psalms 144 and 9. And then I want you to flip over a few pages to Psalm 150. Is that all right? Amen. Psalms 144 and 9. And then Psalms 50, 150. It is musicians appreciation. Is that right? And so we do want to speak according to them. Amen. If you have it, say, I got it. Psalms 144 and 9 says, I will sing a new song to you, O God, on a harp of 10 strings. I will sing praises to you. Notice the last clause of that text. It says, I will. I will sing praises to you. Flip over to Psalms 150. And the Bible says, praise the Lord. Praise God in his sanctuary. Praise him in the firmament of his power. Praise him for his mighty acts. Praise him for his excellent greatness. Then he gets to the instruments. He says, praise him with the sound of the trumpet. Praise him with the lute and harp. Praise him with the timbrel and dance. Praise him with the string instruments and flute. Praise him with the loud cymbals and the crashing cymbals. And then verse 6 says, let everything that has breath praise ye the Lord. For a few moments, I want to talk from the subject, a reminder to the musicians. You may be seated. A reminder to the musicians. Most musicians and singers were born gifted. They were born with music inside of them. I am a musician and a singer as well, and so I've been singing since 5 years old. I've been playing piano since 13 years old.
And I've come to realize that God has blessed me with a gift. Amen? Amen. During that time, I also understood that my gift needed to be molded and shaped and cultivated, and so I had to get training. I can't just be gifted alone, but I have to enhance my gift. I also understood as a musician that music has been around for a long time. Music has become a necessity to life. Have you ever had a moment in your life where you needed some song to help cheer you up? Have you ever had a song when you was down and you was crying and you just needed a lifter of your head and the words of Amazing Grace, how sweet the sound came to you, and you begin to feel just a little bit better because of the music? Now watch this. As I was growing up and as I began to cultivate and motivate my gift, people started patting me on the back, telling me that I sing good and I play well and, you know, you sound good and you sing well. And being at age 13 and 14 years old, it got to my head a little bit. Can I keep it 100 in here? It got so bad to where I got a little popular around my hometown. And folks started knowing my name and who I was, and I began to get invitations to pretty much all the churches around the town, and I became a little popular. Now, with the popularity became a longing for wanting to be compensated for my gift. I'm going somewhere. Follow me. I wanted to get compensated for my gift. And so in being popular, I wasn't taking too many free engagements, even though I was only 14 years old. I became a person of ego. Can I help somebody in here today? I became a person who was all about me, myself, and I, because people made me feel that way. A reminder to the musicians. Mm-hmm. Popularity came, and then the love offerings start coming. And then as more of the love offerings start coming, and as older as I got, the gigs became more and more. I started getting more places to sing and play, and I thought I was doing something. And then at age 15, bless her heart, Rose Benoit, who was the piano player at our church, she was 72 years old. She passed away, and I was asked to play at two churches at 15 years old with two salaries. Can I help somebody in here? A reminder to the musicians. I was at two churches, one at 9 o'clock, going, traveling with the pastor at 11 o'clock. 9 o'clock, I'm at the St. Mark Baptist Church in Cade, Louisiana. 11 o'clock, I'm at the New Zion Baptist Church in New Iberia, Louisiana. And here it is, I'm 15 years old, making two salaries at a church. You know I don't know how to act. I done got to school, I'm bragging to all the kids and, you know, all of my friends and my peers. Man, I'm not playing at one church, I'm playing at two. With two salaries. A reminder to the musicians. Watch this. Notice I never said, God bless me to play for both churches. I said that I am playing for two churches. With two salaries. Notice I never gave God the credit. I never said that God has blessed me with the gift and the opportunity to bless two churches with the gift that he's given me responsible of, because it was all about me.
That's good.
Now watch this. With an ego, you get on the keyboard and you get a microphone in your hand, and it's really not about God, it's about you. And so here it is, you're in church. Is it really about giving God back your gift or pleasing the people? a reminder to the musicians. And it got so to where I was looking more for the applause of people rather than the glory and the honor from God. A reminder to the musicians. I got so caught up to where I was on my way to a revival. And my vehicle was going about 60, 65 miles an hour, and the anti-lock locked up while I was driving. I veered off the highway, and I crossed over a ditch, and I was still going by 60 miles an hour, and my vehicle was headed straight for a flagpole in the post office parking lot. By this time, I'm praying. I'm saying, Lord, I sure don't want to die like this. Forgive me for everything I've done. And God, if you spared my life, I would turn my life around. As soon as I prayed that prayer, the whole left tire came off, which made my vehicle veer from hitting the flagpole head on. Blessing number one. Miracle number one. So as I'm still heading, I end up in the ditch, and my whole vehicle like this. I have an SUV, and it's like this, face down in the ditch. And when I finally came to myself, the front of the vehicle was on fire. So I have another prayer. God, I sure don't want to die like this. And if you get me out of this, Lord, I promise you, I'll turn my life around. Not even 5 or 10 minutes later, people begin to start seeing what was going on. And I got a lot of people around the vehicle, but nobody's helping. They see the fire in front of me. They see all what's going on. A reminder to the musicians. They see all what was going on, and none of them could help me. But God. I'm not here by accident this morning, but God. There was a fireman that showed up about 10 minutes later, and he told me to take my suit coat off and cover myself. And when I covered myself, they busted out both the driver's side and the passenger side. And him and two other men somehow got me out of my SUV. Not 10 minutes later, the whole SUV went up in the flames. The whole vehicle burned crisp. After that, I got a whole new perspective on what it means for God to allow me to use my gift. A reminder to the musicians, don't never get to a place where you leave God out of what all God has blessed you to do. It's not about how well you play. It's not about how well you sing. It's not about how well you praise dance. But it's all about giving God what he deserves. And God deserves the glory. A reminder to the musicians. Can I get to the text and then I'll be through? If you notice here, everybody's familiar with Psalms 150. You heard it over and over again, but I believe God has given me something a little different for us to look at. Is that all right? All right. Yes. The first thing I want you to think about when you look at Psalms 150, who was David talking to? I mean, let's look at it, y'all. The first thing he says is praise the Lord. Yes. You don't just tell a stranger praise the Lord. All right. He had to be addressing somebody specific. Come on here, right. And so the question is, who was David referring to when he said praise the Lord? Not only praise the Lord, but he's talking to some folks who are playing instruments. Somebody go get it in a minute. Somebody, I used to be slow in school too, so I'm going to help you this morning. Is that all right? He's addressing somebody who's playing instruments. But now watch this. Why does David have to be emphatic about reminding whoever he's talking to praise the Lord? Why should he have to remind somebody to praise the Lord? All right, let me see if I can get him New Millennium real quick.
the praise and worship leader, the minister of music, Sister Alice, Bishop Slater, Sister Lady Donna should never have to remind you. To praise the Lord. I mean, I know you dressed up. I know you're looking good. You got on your makeup. You got on your suit. But is there anybody in here have to be reminded of what it means to praise the Lord? If you don't know what it means, let me give you just a few reasons. He woke you up this morning. He started you on your way. The reason that you're breathing is the simple fact that God is worthy to you. So why on some Sundays should you be reminded? You know how I know he was talking to church folk? Because David says, praise him in the sanctuary. It's right here in the text. Y'all see it, don't you? He had to be talking to church folk. Why does he have to remind folk that are in church to praise the Lord? I mean, what did you really come here for this morning? Did you come to spectate or did you come to participate? There are some folks this morning didn't even wave your hand. There are some folks this morning didn't even open up your mouth. But can I remind you of how good God is? That God watched over you all week long. He protected you all week long. There are some folks in jail right now wishing they could be in your place. There are some folks in the hospital right now wishing they could be in your place. Nobody should have to remind you to praise God in the sanctuary. David says, I don't know why, but let me remind you that the sanctuary is a place to praise God. He reminds us to praise the Lord. Then he says, praise him in the sanctuary. Then he says, praise him in the firmament of his power. Now, I told y'all I used to be in school too. I was a little slow in school, so I asked the Lord, what does that word firmament means? I never heard that. They didn't teach us that in school. They didn't teach us firmament. Everybody say firmament. They didn't teach us that in school, so I had to learn what that word was. And so that word in the Hebrew means rakia. And that word rakia means in the expansion of his power. All right, somebody missed it. Y'all just don't know when to shout. And so here's what David is saying. It is important for you to praise the Lord because while you're praising, he's expanding your power. I wish I had somebody in here who know that you need power to fight the devil. And you can't fight the devil by yourself. And so you need some firmament in this house so that God can expand your power. I wish I had somebody that would open up your mouth and say, God, give me more firmament. How many know you can't fight the devil by yourself? You tried it and it didn't work. But all of you open up your mouth and give God praise. God has a way of expanding your power. He's going to give you more power. He's going to give you power to say, no weapon formed against me shall prosper. He's going to give you more power to say, greater is he that is within me than he that is in the world. Somebody say, I need more firmament. Praise is going to expand your power. That's why every chance you get, you better praise the Lord. Because I don't know about you, but at times in my life, I am powerless. Have you ever felt in your life that you had a situation that you couldn't control, that you had no power or control over? Yeah. You felt powerless. But I'm glad that God has given us a word today to let us know if I open my mouth, He's going to expand. He's going to give you the rakia. The rakia, the firmament. He's going to expand your power. That's good stuff, isn't it? That dudamus, yes, sir. The dudamus power. Now watch this. Bishop Slater, I've discovered something. That there's nowhere in the Bible recorded where praise is silent praise. For those of you who say it don't take all that, I ain't gotta shout like that, I ain't gotta open up my mouth like that, let me help you this morning. That is nowhere in the Bible. That is nowhere in the scripture where praise is quiet. Everywhere I saw in the scripture, praise is active. You've got to open up your mouth. You've got to wave your hands. You've got to give God what He deserves. So if I were you, I would stop trying to be cute and I would open up my mouth. Tell somebody next to you, praise is not silent. So the next time you hear somebody say that, you ask them to show you a book, chapter, and a verse. If they tell you it don't take all that, that praise can be quiet, you tell them show you a book, a chapter, and a verse. Because the Bible clearly says that we ought to praise the Lord. Watch this. Watch this. David reminds them to praise the Lord in the sanctuary. He reminds all of us that we ought to praise Him for the rakia, for the expansion of our power. Then he says, praise Him for His mighty acts. Let me ask you something. Has the Lord done anything for you that you know it was nobody but Him? I mean, don't fool me, don't clap, don't wave your hands, but I need some folk in here who can testify that I was in trouble on my way to hell and it was nobody but Jesus. Is there anybody here that just can wave their hands and say it was nobody but Jesus that got me out of my trouble? Watch this. Watch this. I just need about two or three folk to shout with me on this, and we have church all by ourselves. It's a reason why I praise God, and the reason why I praise God like I do, Bishop Slater, is because some stuff He should have exposed on me a long time ago. Come on, I just need about two or three that would agree with me and say, some time ago, the sheet should have came off. Some time ago, God should have exposed me a long time ago. But aren't you glad that He covered you? Even while you were messed up, you were on your way to hell, while you were having so many issues, God covered you. You ought to praise God that He covered you. You ain't been saved all your life. Come on, I wish you would keep it real. Some of us used to drink. Some of us used to smoke. Some of us had doing things that we ain't had no business. But all the blood of Jesus, what can wash away my sins? What can make me whole again? Somebody say nothing. I've got to praise him for his mighty acts. Watch this. Watch this. Some of us need to praise God on credit. Some of us need to praise God on credit because there are some things he done for us 2 and 3 years ago that we still haven't told him thank you for. So I need some folk in here who can praise God on credit right now, because there are some things he's done for you just last week, 3 months ago, that you forgot to tell him thank you for. Open up your mouth and tell God thank you. My God, my God. I feel like preaching in here. All right. All right. All right. Now watch this. Watch this. Watch this. My God. My God. Some of y'all just think about it. You was about to lose your mind. You was depressed. You was having a pity party. You wasn't even getting dressed. You was in the bed. Anybody remember those times when you was lonely, when you thought that nobody cared, nobody was there for you? Aren't you glad that God never gave up on you? He may not come when you want him, but God is always. Yeah. Not yet. I don't want to go there yet. I don't want to go there yet. Watch this. Watch this. Watch this. Now, while David is in a church setting, he notices something. He notices something because he starts looking at the musician's pit. David starts looking at the musician's pit, and he notices that the musicians are playing the instruments. But now let's watch what the text says. He noticed that they're playing the instruments. David gets emphatic again. He doesn't say play the instruments. Look what he says. He says, praise him with the sound of the trumpet. Praise him with the lute and harp. Praise him with the timbrel and dance. Praise him with the instruments and flute. Now watch this. Notice David never says to play the instruments. A reminder to the musicians that every now and then, y'all ought to see the musicians lifting their hands. Every now and then, you ought to see a musician giving God praise. Not to just play the instruments, but God's been good to you too. God has brought you out of some stuff too. The least you can do as a musician, because he's giving you the gift, is to lift your hands and give God glory, because he's worthy of it. Watch this, musicians. Watch this. He's worthy of it because you didn't get the gift by yourself. I wish I had a church in here. You didn't get the gift on your own. It was because God gave it to you. So if you have no other reason, The least you can do is praise God, because your gift that you have, he gave it to you. It's a reason why you can play the drums. It's a reason why you can play the organ. It's a reason why you can direct. It's because God gave it to you. And I don't know about you, but I'm a musician, and I made up in my mind, if I've got to get off the keyboard sometimes, I'm going to get off. If I got to lay my hands in the air all by myself and forget about it, because don't you know it's important, for the congregation to see the musicians praising? Musicians and worship leaders, you're trying to constantly tell everybody or motivate everybody else to praise God, but they never see you. That's why David had to remind them. David saw them playing and trying to usher other folks into the presence of God, but they never see the musicians praising God. Sunday after Sunday, the musicians, the praise leaders, this is for praise and worship team, dance, I don't care who you are. You are motivated to usher the people in the pew into the presence of God. It is your responsibility that they see it from you first. Y'all got it? That's why David's saying it is important not for you to play. It is already understood because you're on the instrument. Why do you think David was very specific about the instruments that they were playing? Because they were already on the instrument. But now what he didn't see was that they were praising him on the instrument. I know it's going to get quiet. I know. David reminds the musicians that playing is all right. But at times folk need to see you praising. So many times in church, sometimes we feel that the pastor, the musicians are exempt from trouble because they hold a leadership role. Whether you want to admit it or not, they do. They think you're Superman. They think we got an S on our chest, that we can't never go through nothing. We can't never have problems because we the pastor, or we the praise and worship leader, or don't you know pastor oftentimes need prayer too? Don't you know that the musicians need prayer too? I know you see them every Sunday and they are skillful, they are playing, they are in their post, but they can be playing and smiling on the outside while frowning and being unhappy on the inside. So David had to remind the musicians too that we ought not just play with it, but we need to praise God too. All right, watch this, and then I'm done. Now, for those of you who thought that we left you out, I'm about to go to my seat, but you're not a praise and worship leader, you're not a pastor, you're not a musician. You thought you was left out. I'm so glad that David covered everybody. Because in verse 6, he says, let everything. That has black. Praise the Lord. Watch this. If you are breathing right now, is not promised to you when you walk out that door. Let me tell you why. I had an aunt on Tuesday morning, went in for a procedure. My dad was already in the hospital, and she went to see him in the room. Her procedure was at 2:30, and she went in the room. My brother and my mom was in there, and they was joking and laughing and clowning all morning. She went in for her procedure at 2:30 and didn't make it, went cold blue. That fast, she was gone. A reminder to everybody that life is not promised to you. When you leave this door, I'll be preaching her funeral next Saturday. Life is not promised to you when you leave out of this door. So let me get back to the text. Let everything. If you're breathing, if you're able to clap your hands, if you're able to stand on your feet, if you're able to open up your mouth, the Bible says that you are to praise. The Bible says that you are to praise the Lord. While the blood is running warm in your veins, you ought to praise the Lord. I need to ask you a question and then I'm going to go to my seat. Has the Lord been good to you? Has the Lord ever made a way for you? Has he ever opened doors? Then you ought to praise his name. The Bible says, let the redeemer of the Lord say so. If the Lord has blessed your soul, say so. If the Lord has ever healed your body, say so. If the Lord has ever made a way for you, somebody ought to open your mouth and say so. Has he ever put food on your table? Say so. Has he ever helped you pay your bills? Say so. Has the Lord ever gave you a job? Say so. Can somebody in here wave your hand and say so? Somebody say, Lord, I thank you. Lord, I bless you. Lord, I give you glory. I need you to do me one favor. And I promise you, I'm going to my seat. Catch your neighbor by the hand. Ooh. Catch your neighbor. Neighbor. Catch your neighbor by the hand. And tell a neighbor, you're looking at a survivor. You're looking at somebody who should have been dead, sleeping in my grave. But the Lord came, picked me up, turned me around, placed my feet on solid ground. If you believe it, say yay, say yay, say yay, yay, yay. Through the fire, and I've been through the flood. I've gone through heartache, and I've gone through trials. But through it all, I still got my joy. Joy woke me up this morning. Joy started me on my way. My grandmama said, this joy that I have, the world didn't give it. Aye, aye. The world didn't give it. And the world can't take it away. Somebody say, I got it. Aye, I got it. Aye, I got it. Anybody got that joy that won't leave you by yourself? Anybody got that joy?
Somebody say, I got it. Somebody say, I got it. Yeah. 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 I got it. I got it. I got the joy. I got one story for you, then I'm going to take my seat. There was this old man that was plowing in the fields. And as he was plowing through the fields, his two children walked up to him, daughter and a brother, and they told daddy that they wanted him to come to church with them next Sunday. Now, they told daddy, you can come with us, but daddy, we need to remind you that we are a sophisticated church. We don't do all that shouting and carrying on at our church. So the daddy said, well, I don't need to go to your church if I can't praise my God. Yeah. Yeah. But now watch this. The daughter and the son said, okay, daddy, we understand. They said, I'll tell you what we do. If you come and act civilized at our church, we'll buy you some new boots. So grandfather said, new boots? He looked down at his shoes and he noticed he needed some new boots. So daddy said, okay, I'll come. I'll come to your church because I need a new pair of boots. Next Sunday came around, and daddy got on that front row where all the other deacons was, and they began to have devotion. Father God, Lord Jesus, we come to you as best as we know how, giving you praise, honor, and glory. And daddy began to shake his head. And his children were sitting behind him. And as he began to shake his head, his daughter touched him on the back and said, daddy, remember, you can't do that. Boots, boots. You remember, daddy? And so daddy stopped right where he was. And then the choir starts singing, I need thee. Oh, I need thee. Yeah. We I need thee. And then daddy stood up. Daddy started shaking like this because it started getting good to him. And finally his son tapped him on the back, Bishop. His son said, daddy, remember those boots, daddy. Finally, the preacher got up and the preacher began speaking. And then the preacher got to one Friday night. Y'all know what he did, don't you? He died. The moon stopped shining. He died. Stayed there Friday night, all day, Saturday morning, and even Saturday night. But hey, 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 he got up. And by that time, daddy got up and started shouting. Daddy got up and started moving. Daddy got up and praised God. And finally, the daughter tried to come and stop daddy from praising God. She tapped daddy on the shoulder and said, daddy, remember those boots, 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 daddy. Daddy finally turned around and told the daughter, boots are no boots. Praise God. Daddy said, you don't know like I know. What is that for me? I don't need no boots. I'll praise him all by myself. And is there anybody in here like daddy that you don't need your neighbor? You don't need no organ. You will praise God. Is there anybody in here that know that you know that you know that God is good? My daddy used to sing a song, and he used to say, I'm so glad Jesus lifted me. When I was in trouble, Jesus lifted me. When I didn't have a dime, Jesus lifted me. When I didn't have nothing else, when nothing else could help, Jesus, Jesus, oh Jesus, Jesus lifted me. And anybody else in here that can testify that when you was in trouble, Jesus lifted me when nothing else could help.
I just pray, Lord, that you continue to bless him to preach on him, Father. Preach him to heaven is satisfied. Hell is horrified. And God, you glorify. We bless your name right now. We minister to his spirit, O Heavenly Father. Restore him, O Heavenly Father. Everything, O Heavenly Father, that he's poured out, God, you pour back in. In the name of Jesus, we thank you. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Come on, let's give God some praise in the house. Come on, give God some praise in the house. That's a reminder. Not just to the musicians, that's a reminder to us. Hello, somebody. That everything that has breath ought to praise God. If you don't think God has done nothing for you, just look around you. You're able to see. You're able to feel. You're able to open up your mouth. You're able to walk in here. Even if you didn't walk in here, if somebody just rolled you in here, just like the man who was at the pool of Bethesda, sometimes you have a way. And you ought to say thank you. Bless the Lord. Amen. Everybody stand to your feet. We're not going to be long. We're going to go on. Amen. There's an invitation that's going to be given right now. And what the invitation is, it's your opportunity. If you haven't accepted Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, and you want to be reminded, you want to be reminded that mama did it, daddy did it, grandmama did it, but guess what? You have to do it yourself. What invitation is your opportunity to say, Lord, I want to accept Jesus Christ as my Lord and Savior. If you're saved, sanctified, hello, somebody. You feel as though you've been set apart. With you, if you don't have a church home or a place of worship where you can work out your soul salvation, with you, you're reminded that men and women ought to always come together and pray and not faint. Hello, somebody. And so you need a place of worship. You need a place where you can have a partnership. We don't join here. Amen. You unite in the body of Christ. Amen. You join clubs and all that stuff, but guess what? When you come into the body of Christ, you unite into the body. Amen. If you are a saved individual, you are the local church. Amen. So I want to give that opportunity to you. Maybe you have a letter from somewhere. Amen. And you said, Bishop, I need a place of worship. Amen. I'm coming from out of town and I haven't found a church home. And man, it sounds pretty good up here. I need to let you know. And I want people to understand this. We love our musicians. Amen. And I believe they worship God. Hello, somebody. And what you see in here that you saw today, that's on a regular. I'm just saying it like it is. Amen. This ain't nothing because of something special. They are special. But we love praising God like this on a regular.
Because God deserves our praise. Amen. God deserves our worship. Yes, there are Sundays when we all feel bad. Yes, there are Sundays we don't want to do nothing. But you know what? When I walk into the sanctuary of God, it just seems like something happens in my body. No matter what pains I'm having, those pains dissipate. No matter what challenges I've been having, all of a sudden God said, oh, you went into the worship zone. This is a place where you worship God. You worship God for who he is. You praise him for the things that he has done. Sing it. Mm-hmm. But let me tell you what you have to do. If you're going to come into the kingdom or unite at this local church, you have to do it on your own. Nobody can help you. If you feel the Holy Spirit moving on your heart right now and you say, I need to do this, I'm going to pray for you right now. And at the end of my prayer, I want you to just boldly step out, come down this aisle, give me your hand, but give God your heart. That's what you have to. Father God, we bless you and we thank you for the preacher. We thank you for the word that reminds us, oh Heavenly Father, we ought to praise you. God, there's somebody here today, oh Heavenly Father, need a church home, need a place of worship, need a place where them and their families can reside and develop a new family, a culture of honor, a culture of praise, a culture of respect, a culture that is transparent. Don't mind talking about our issues because we may be going through some of the same things. So I pray for that heart right now, that one who needs to come down today, right now, in the name of Jesus. God, I thank you in Jesus' name. Amen. If you hear my brother, my sister, don't you delay. Just come on down. Amen. While the blood is running warm in your vein, don't you let nothing stop you. You just come. You just come. Say, Bishop, I want to come. Just raise your hand if you want to come. If you want to come down, I'll come get you. But you need to come. You need to come. You need to have a place of worship. The devil been messing with you. He's been tearing your tail up. And he tears all our tail up. But you know what? I got some help. Amen. I got some Holy Ghost filled people who are around me that are praying for me. And when I get weak, that's when I become strong. Can everybody sing that? I love you, Jesus. Come on, everybody sing. Oh. Just want to tell you, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. Hey, I love you, Jesus. Just want to tell you that I love you more. Hallelujah. Father God, I just bless you. I bless you for that heart, Lord, that's right there, Lord, at that point, oh Heavenly Father. I plead your blood right now over their finances. Lord, I plead your blood over their life, their family, a sick relative. They've lost a loved one, or a loved one has transitioned. But God, you know. You know they need that job, oh Heavenly Father. But right now is the time to go it on and release it and give it to you. So God, we stand right now in the name of Jesus, Lord, asking for your power of release in this house, upon that heart that's closest to hell. Reclaim the backsliding. Give strength to those who are trying to stay on this battlefield. In the name of Jesus, we thank you. Amen. 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 Bless the Lord. Bless the Lord. Bless the Lord in this place. Amen. Amen. Go on and sing it. Sing it. Sing it. Sing it. Let me say this. If you're a first-time guest, amen, we're going to let our first-time guests go first, amen. We're going to be leaving. We're going to be going to the back. They're going to get information from you, amen, and in some kind of way. We got it all messed up back there, amen. But you can give them a clipboard, and they can do it while they're sitting at the table, amen. And we want to let all the men know, those men who are working, we want to be in a serving position. Young men, you can go back there and sit back there. Yes, ma'am. Come on, Pastor. Okay, I'm just... Amen. So you can do that. Amen. And I'm going to let Pastor Slater, she's going to conduct from this point on. Amen. But we want to let you know we love you. We're going to have a good time. Amen. And it's beautiful outside, so we might put some tables outside for the children. Amen.
Come with me. Come on. Amen. Praise the Lord. Somebody say, what a word. What a word. Amen. How many been hoped today? How many been hoped today? Amen. Amen. We're going to ask if our musicians, if y'all could line up in the back. We just want everyone to see y'all strutting the Lord on in here. We bless God for you all. And we just want to present you M Cube. Amen. Amen. Oh, which way did y'all go? That way. Front door. Did I say back door? Amen. And this is Sherry. Where's Brother Joshua? Amen. Everybody give the Lord a praise offering. Amen. Amen. M Cube, if you can play music, please. Amen. Amen. Look at your neighbor. Say, neighbor, don't get distracted. We still praising God. Say, we're still in worship. Because the Bible says, give honor to whom honor is due. Amen. And any labor that you do in the Lord. Amen. Would you go back here? Wait, no. Thank you. That labor which you do in the Lord, you give God the glory for. Amen.
Honestly, for the same people,
amen.
Life can be so real. I'm amazed by all.
1 Corinthians 4, 1 through 5 says, let a man so consider us as servants of Christ and stewards of the mysteries of God. Moreover, it is required in stewards that one be found faithful. But with me, it is a very small thing that I should be judged by you, or by a human court. In fact, I do not even judge myself, for I know of nothing against myself. Yet I am not justified by this, but he who judges me is the Lord. Therefore, judge nothing before the time, until the Lord comes, who will bring the light to the hidden things of darkness and reveal the counsels of the hearts. Then each one's praise will come from God. 1 Corinthians 4, 1 through 5. Would everyone please rest upon your feet as we honor the musicians, the ministers of music.